My name is Jeff Royal. I'm the archaeologist and archaeology director for RPM Nautical Foundation. I received my doctorate at Texas A&M University and have been working here since 2003. The foundation was begun in 2001 by founder George Robb, who was an Institute of Nautical Archaeology director, became very interested in the field and thought that he would like to start a foundation to do some of the things in the Mediterranean that weren't being conducted at the time. As you can see from what we have on the ship, that was applying some of the latest technology to the search and recovery of shipwrecks at depth beyond diver depth. We've begun in an area that the ministry was very interested in, this Risan and Kotor bays, completing the mapping of these, and then we're moving out to the front on the coastline, and we'll begin what I hope is a program to do the entire Montenegrin coast out to the 110 meter contour. The research vessel Hercules came online in 2004 when we first placed it on a project in Cadiz, Spain. From there, we've had the vessel in continuous operation each field season, based out of Malta, and we've had the vessel augmented several times. It's had several changes both to the A-frame and the equipment we've got on board in the data room. And I believe now we're to a point where the vessel is one of the finest for what it does in the Mediterranean. And with this vessel, we're able to easily survey on the shorelines and in the shallower waters. And by shallower, I mean to 100, 200, 300 meters of depth, and do that very effectively. On board the Hercules, we've assembled specialists, very experienced and with high credentials in all of their specific fields. All of us have to pitch in and help each other in their fields, but the individuals we do have are some of the best known, or some of the best qualified within them, specifically the ROV, our imaging technology and survey technology with our surveyors.
My name is Christian Llewellyn. I'm from Canada. I'm the chief surveyor here on board the Hercules. So I'm in charge of running our mapping equipment. On board here, our primary mapping tool is called a multi-beam sonar. The controls for this is what you see in this screen right here. So what happens is we have this special piece of equipment underneath the ship, and it shoots out under the boat with hundreds of beams of sound all underneath the ship. So what we do is, you can see here, we run the ship in these long parallel lines here all over the ocean, and the ship maps everywhere the boat goes. So the sonar will see the seabed everywhere that we go. So far we've mapped all up here in the Bay of Kotor here, and now we are mapping down here right along the coast. And our plan is, if we're invited back in future seasons, to continue all the way down the coast, all the way to the southern end of the country. So once we collect all this information about the seabed, we display it over here. And the nice thing about our software here is we can view everything all in three dimensions. So we can spin it around and rotate it, and we have very good visualization of the seabed. And what we're looking for is tiny little bumps on these maps that we make. And once we find these little bumps, we mark down the coordinates of them, and we send our ROV down to look at them.
I'm Kim Wilson, and I'm the ROV pilot and technician. ROV is remotely operated vehicle. This is a CI Panther. The CI comes from the United Kingdom, and the Panther XT is rated to 1,500 meters. Most of our work is at 100 meters, where we find most of the interesting artifacts. The vehicle is all electric. We do have a hydraulic power pack that's run by electrics for our front manipulators, for our front arms, so we can pick things up, and we can excavate with a water jet and a suction tube. This part is the ROV, which it comes out of this cage, which is the TMS, tether management system. The tether is the string that the ROV works from, and I can control this inside. So I can pedal out and bring the tether out or bring it in. We work about 100 meters away from the TMS. The TMS will be in the water at 10 meters off the bottom, and the ROV goes off to do its work. This is the front of the ROV. We have four LED lights, large lights. It's about 1200 watts total power, which I can adjust individually for brightness. We have the main pilot's camera in the center. Above that here is a still camera for still photography. We also have a small camera here on this. These are called manipulators that I can control from inside to open the jaws, rotate. We can lift things up, small artifacts. We have a high pressure water jet, which helps us if we have an amphora or an artifact on the seabed. We can excavate the mud around it and then try to pick it up. We don't pick up anything unless the local archaeologist asks us to. We pretty much just document whatever we find.
Today was a very a good day for us. We've gone out and began to identify targets with the ROV. One of the first few that we found were some of the targets that appeared to be modern wrecks. One of these turned out to be a submarine. Had fore and aft torpedo launches, and it may very well be a World War I date. We've also found another vessel, metal, modern, with a very narrow, long vessel. This could also be from the first or second World War date. And a third we also wanted to film and get more film of. We also moved into the bay today and began to look in the Risan Bay area. Discovered several fragmentary amphoras. Very surprised, since we have high sedimentation rates, that we were finding material on the surface. We were. A lot of it was partially buried, of course. These appear to be Greek in origin. Further analysis will need to be done, better photography. But this is also exciting. We're going to continue to work in that area and see if we can locate the shipwreck where a lot of these fragments have come from. As we come to the end of the project, it's been very exciting and rewarding. The discoveries thus far tantalize us for future seasons and the great discoveries that can be made here in Montenegro. Looking at what we have thus far, it is evident that there will be some great value in discovering and identifying the cultural resources for the people of Montenegro to protect and to help drive their tourism and a self-identity within their culture.